Hey guys, welcome back to Real Estate Informed, the channel that keeps you up to date on all things real estate. Okay, so 2 days ago I did a video about Zillow, and Zillow said that they're going to stop the iBuyer program and the reasons why they're doing it, and everyone thinks that it's some sort of real estate crash that's happening. And I said that it's just the fact that Zillow sucks and that their management and them hiring 200 employees and those employees not knowing what they're doing or not knowing the real estate industry is causing Zillow to lose a lot of money, and that's why they're probably going to pause till 2022, restructure that business, iBuyer business that they have, and then come at it again. I think the reason that they were losing so much money on their properties was they were trying to use a business model that they undercut their competition, gain market share, and get everyone on the platform of iBuying and getting used to that and using technology and then raising the prices from there. But they were losing so much money and so much inexperience working with contractors and whatnot that it just, you know, wasn't working. They were bleeding way too much money. It had nothing to do with the real estate crash. So now this is a follow-up video where apparently there's another article out now that's saying that Zillow is selling 7,000 homes to either BlackRock or to some big real estate REIT or to some other, you know, major investor, not some small and pop, mom and pop, that they can sell it in bulk and just get rid of it. And everyone's sitting there, once again, all these YouTube videos and, you know, YouTube people talking about this is a crash. No, this is just Zillow being stupid and Zillow not knowing what they're doing, and they're going into markets that they don't know anything about and them screwing up. And I think that they know that they screwed up. They overpaid for houses. There was an article, you guys can go find it online. There was, it says something of that 66% of Zillow's houses that they have sold, they sold for less than what they bought them for, which is ridiculous. So I think Zillow knew that they hired 2,000 employees, set up this whole iBuyer system, and it screwed up. And they, the people that they hired know nothing about real estate. And, you know, I think people were just getting jobs from Zillow, not having any real qualifications of, you know, flipping houses, because that's the business that you're in, is flipping houses. And Zillow was hiring these local people from their certain local metropolitans, and they were screwing up. And this particular area was Arizona, Phoenix, where they were really, really screwing up. And that's where the majority of the houses that they're going to use that they're going to sell. So once again, not a real estate crash. This is just Zillow screwing up, and their stock is absolutely plummeting. But that has nothing to do with real estate. If you want to see real estate values go down, you have to see increase in inventory and a decrease in demand. And right now, we do not see that. So all these you know, articles and YouTube videos talking about Zillow's crashing the market, simply not true. So do some research for yourself. Leave in the questions or comments, you know, down below. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. All right, thanks guys. Bye.